2019 is turning out to be the summer of franchises for collectors with themes such as Marvel Endgame, Lego Movie 2, Detective Pikachu, the Star Wars 20th Anniversary, Masters of the Universe, Batman 80th Anniversary, and many, many more. Today we're going to take a look at a franchise that started 24 years ago and became an instant classic with its first movie. Hi everyone, I'm Mac, and this is Toy Story.
You got a friend in me. You've got a friend in me. When the road looks...
In 1995, the first Toy Story movie hit theaters and the world smiled. The idea of toys coming to life and living secret lives, dedicated to the happiness and well-being of the children they belong to, is a universal theme that all people can relate to. Who didn't imagine their toys had lives and emotions of their own? Since the first movie from the 90s, Toy Story has had numerous sequels and spun off into video games, holiday specials, direct-to-video movies, ice shows, musicals, and much more. Including now a series of Lego sets based on the newest big-screen sequel to the franchise, Toy Story 4. Not too bad for a movie that suffered production shutdown in its initial stages. To coincide with the release of the fourth movie this month, Lego has released six Toy Story 4 sets. We don't have all of them here today, and why we don't, I'll explain in a bit. But what we do have is set 10771, the Carnival Thrill Coaster, and set 10767, Duke Kaboom's Stunt Show. Each of the sets is a 4-plus set, meaning they are meant for children and have large pieces that make it easy for small hands to play with. First up, we have the Carnival Thrill Coaster. If you've seen the trailers for Toy Story 4, then you know that a large part of the movie, or at least the trailers, is a toy-built amusement park or a carnival. And that is what most of the Toy Story 4 sets are based around. This set, as you can tell by the name, is based around a roller coaster. All of the sets are very colorful, much like the movies have been, with the most predominant color being the purple coaster track that makes a simple loop track for the coaster to travel around. The coaster itself is designed to look like a caterpillar. A very, very happy caterpillar. And if the design on the front car of the coaster doesn't tell you that, then there's a printed tile piece on the front of the coaster entrance that shows you just what it's supposed to be. Like all 4-plus sets, and previously the junior sets, there are no stickers here. Everything you see is a printed piece. The entrance to the coaster is complete with a turnstile made up of translucent yellow and orange pieces. The coaster itself moves smoothly around the track. In addition, it comes with a snack cart, complete with a popsicle, pizza, and a red balloon. The minifigs that come with the set are one of the little green men from the claw machine and Buzz Lightyear himself. To be honest, the minifigs that come with the set was my main influence on which ones I was going to buy. The little green man has a uniform, blue in color, and is fitted with short legs that I believe were originated with the Harry Potter sets, which of course means his legs don't bend. As unimpressive as the figure is, the head sculpt for this little guy is great. He captures the charm and sweetness of the animated characters, and when you look at the pursed lips of his face, you can almost hear him saying... Buzz Lightyear was one of the minifigs that I was looking forward to with these sets. The minifig bears a reasonable resemblance to his animated persona. The coloring is decent but slightly bland, and the mold of Buzz's spacesuit is well done. The wings have a nice sculpt to them as well, but also like the rest of the suit, the coloring is still slightly bland. The wings can be removed from Buzz's backpack to simulate them being folded into his suit. The dome of the helmet is only a half dome. It doesn't come with a full headpiece, and I have to admit, I'm a little disappointed by that. Buzz only has one face, and the face that he comes with is Buzz's trademark lopsided smile and dimpled chin. The coloring, however... well, you can probably see for yourself. The coloring is bad. A grayish purple, and it looks as if the paint for the face wasn't heavy enough to cover the purple of the rest of the headpiece. I don't know if it's just mine, or if this is how they all come out, but it is very disappointing. When you take off Buzz's spacesuit piece, he has a print on his torso that is the symbol of Star Command. I was drawn to Duke Kaboom's Stunt Show because I used to love the motorcycle stunt riders of old. Riders like Evel Knievel, who Duke Kaboom was obviously modeled after. The centerpiece of this set is a motorcycle stunt ramp. At one end is the ramp itself that is supposed to send the motorcycle and rider jumping over the toy cars and through the ring of fire at the other end. I think of this build, my favorite part is the Ring of Fire, made up of translucent orange pieces with some very nicely colored flame pieces. The Ring of Flame has a nice look to it. As I said, the set also comes with a pair of simple twin toy cars that are used for Duke Kaboom to jump over. And the set also comes with a nice little build that is an advertising billboard for Kaboom Stunt Show. As with all of the Toy Story 4 sets, Duke Kaboom Stunt Show is very brightly colored, being predominantly red and white, like Duke himself, which we'll see in a moment. As with the Carnival Thrill Coaster, Duke Kaboom Stunt Show comes with two figures, Woody and Duke himself. Woody is what you would expect from this minifig. Actually, it's more than what you'd expect. The legs are dual-molded, blue and brown to represent his jeans and his boots, and the torso printing of his cowhide vest is fantastic. On his back, you can clearly see the pull string that makes Woody talk, and his sheriff star even has a metallic shine to it. On the front of Woody, you can see the pattern of his yellow and red striped flannel shirt, and a touch of red to hint at the scarf he wears around his neck. And finally, we have his signature hat that is a wonderful mold in and of itself. Woody's hair and hat are all one piece. Woody has two faces, and both are happy. And now we have the star himself, and the main reason I bought the set, Duke Kaboom. As I said, Duke is obviously molded after the famous stunt rider, Evel Knievel. Duke's minifig is painted to look like he's wearing a one-piece white jumpsuit with red accents on his feet, stripes running up the sides of his legs, his belt buckle, and a red shirt under his jumpsuit. Duke sports a red cape that is done in the new style for this year, with a single hole that requires no folding of material on itself. Duke also wears a white helmet with a translucent red visor. In addition, he has a hairpiece as well. Duke has two faces, one with a cocky grin, and one of abject terror. Part of the build of this set, Duke also gets a white and red stunt cycle. On the front is a printed disc piece with a Canadian maple leaf proudly displayed. The Toy Story 4 sets are fun for what they are, but unless you are a super fan of the franchise or a completionist, getting all of the sets is an easy pass. The minifigs of Woody and Buzz, as far as I can tell, are all the same. They haven't even given them different facial expressions as they did with Emmett in the LEGO Movie 2 sets. 4 Plus and Junior sets are always a little more expensive per piece than regular ones, mainly because of the large molded pieces, but these Toy Story 4 sets are priced even a little higher than normal. Overpriced and underdesigned and lacking any sort of even the simplest play features, my suggestion is to buy the sets based on what minifigs you want, or just wait until you can buy the minifigs separately on sites like BrickLink. To me, the majority of these sets aren't worth the investment, and once you get them, they'll be tucked away and forgotten. And as we've all seen in the movies, that's exactly what a toy does not want to happen. Hey everyone, thanks for hanging around this long and listening to me talk about Legos and Toy Story. Please don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. If you already are a subscriber, then thank you for supporting the channel. Play well, everyone, and as always, thank you for watching.
You've got a friend in me. You've got a friend in me. When the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed, you just remember what your old past said. Boy, you got a friend in me.